Our first chapter in from the annual topic, that is my, I think there are only two chapters. It is quite interesting also. So let's in this chapter. So first thing we have to learn, what is MySQL? So MySQL is just a software. MySQL is my structured query. The full form of MySQL is my structured query language. So why it is used? Basically, this is a software. MySQL is a software which can create, maintain, and update a database. Okay, that is a relational database. If you remember, last year in MS Access, we have learned about databases. We had created databases also there, and we have created different components of a database there also. But actually, in real life, these databases are not actually created in MS Access. They are mostly created in this kind of software, that is MySQL. Okay, so how this kind of softwares are, how they are controlling our databases, let us see. Okay, so let's say I'm creating a table. I want a table. We know that whatever a database is, let me circle it for you. Let's say this is a database. Database will have information regarding a certain organization or a certain area of field. Okay, for example, let's say student information you want, you will save them in a particular database. But information about maybe products, let's say Flipkart or Amazon, those products you want to store the information for, you will be storing them in a different database. So for every topic, there are different databases. For every database, there are multiple tables. So you will have some tables here, another table here. All of them might not be of same size. Some of them might be bigger table, some might be smaller table. There are multiple tables out there under a single database. So database is basically a collection of multiple tables together. Okay. So MySQL supports standard SQL, which is the standard language for communicating with an RDBMS. So RDBMS is just means Relational Database Management System. It consists of a number of commands for the purpose. So SQL commands are divided into five categories. So there are a total of five categories of commands which we can use to create, to update, to insert whatever we want in a database. We have five different kinds of commands. Let's see what are these different commands. The first one is DDL. The full form you can see in your book. DDL is Data Definition Language. So what does Data Definition Language mean? So Data Definition Language simply means the commands that we used for creating a database. Just wait. Creating database, creating tables in a database, then changing, modifying, that is altering database. Altering database, altering tables like this. So for these commands, we use what kind of queries, what kind of commands that we use for creating database, for creating tables, for altering database, for altering table, we use data definition language. So if you simply see, a DDL simply means that the process of creating a table, that is the structure that you are creating for a table, that will be the DDL. Okay, the thing that I'm doing right now, I'm trying to draw a table. You can think of it like this. You are drawing a table. How many columns will be there, how many rows will be there, you are deciding. That will be your DDL or data definition language. Is it clear, students? What are DDL commands? Okay. Next thing we have is the DML or data manipulation language. So DMLs are actually used for, since it is saying the data manipulation language, so DML simply means that after we have created our table, the what is the next thing that we want to do? We want to insert values, right? So insert values, then delete values. Modify values or change values. Or C values. So data manipulation language is mainly used for inserting values. That is, after we have created our database, we are creating our database or we are creating our table using the data definition language commands. And after creating those, what is the next thing we want to do? We want to give values to them, right? Let's say 1, 3, 9, like this. We want to give different values. So the process with which we are actually inserting those values, or later on we are changing those values, are controlled by these kinds of command, that is called the data manipulation language. Is it clear, students? The difference between a DDL command and a DML command. DDL commands simply maintain the structure or create the structure of a table, but DML command actually populate the table, that is inserting those values, filling the table up. It is done by DMLs, and creating the structure of the table, it is done by DDL. Okay, the next kind is the TCL or the transaction control language. So what does this mean? TCL statements are used to manage the changes made by the DML statements. So these include commit, rollback, and save point commands. So you can think of it like an ATM counter. Okay, let me first write it. Think of an ATM counter. Okay. So we give our card inside, then we provide our PIN code, then we say that how much money we want to withdraw, then we press on enter and that money comes out, right? But in those processes, something go wrong, right? So that ATM, your whatever ATM you are visiting, it might lose its power, its network connection. For any of those reasons, your transaction could be failed, right? That is, you are saying that you want to withdraw, let's say 10,000 rupees, and it has approved also, and it has deducted that 10,000 from your account. But while giving you that money, there its power is gone and it could not give you that particular amount of money. So transaction is failed. Transaction failed, but it has deducted that same amount from your account already. But you did not get the cash in your hand. So what will happen? You did not have the cash and you don't have that particular amount in your bank account also. So if these things work, then we are losing our money, right? So to safeguard from these kinds of error, that is while doing some kind of transaction, to protect you from those errors, these TCL commands are used, that is transaction control language. For example, in this case, if there is a failed transaction, that is this transaction failed and you did not get the money in your hand, but your money was deducted from your account, then maybe 5 minutes later or 10 minutes later, or maybe the next day, that whole amount will be refunded to your same account. So these are controlled by these three statements. What are these three statements? You see, there are three statements written here. One is called commit. Commit. The next one is called what is it called? Rollback. and the last one is called save point. Okay, so how these are maintained is that, let's say you are doing some kind of transaction. Okay, so after every step, whatever transaction you are in, after every step there will be a save point, so that it will save how much you have progressed in your transaction. Okay, but for any reason, if your transaction is not successful, that is your transaction has failed, it will just roll back. Rolling back simply means it will get to the previous position, that is when you had that particular amount in your account, it will just roll back to that particular position and you will not lose any money. But if your transaction is successful, ultimately, that is the end of your session, if your transaction is successful, it will simply commit, so that whatever changes you have made, those changes become permanent. So you can think of them like undo and redo. Okay, so rollback is working like an undo statement. And commit is working as a save statement. What is the how these are working? That is commit, rollback, and save point. Okay, so this is how this is TCL, that is transaction control language, is safeguarding us from losing our money. Oh, I have only given the example of an ATM. This can be used in some other database also. Okay, so next kind is the DCL, that is data control language. So these statements are used to give or withdraw access privilege to the database user. So these include grant, revoke commands, etc. So these are also used to safeguard us from any kind of fraud. Let me delete all this. The next one was DCL, right? DCL. So you can think of it like when you put our ATM in the ATM card, in ATM machine, then you are asked some password, right? And if you have provided a wrong password, it will not allow you access. And if you have provided a correct PIN, then it will provide you access. Those are maintained by this data control language. So DCL commands will provide you a certain commands called grant and revoke. So grant simply means it will allow you to make modifications. Okay, grant will allow you to make modifications to the database. And there is another command, that is revoke. So it will take that that privilege from you. That is, you, if you are revoked, then you cannot make modifications to that database anymore. So if the database administrator has granted you access, then you can make modifications, you can add new data, or you can change data also. But if that same database administrator has revoked your access, then you cannot anymore change your data or change anyone else's data. Is it clear? TCL, not TCL, DCL. Okay. The last one is DQL, that is data query language. So this includes select, show, help commands. The select is the main DQL command. Okay. So last one is our DQL. The full form is data query language. So data query language is simply used for asking questions. Ask questions to the database. Let's say in our database, we have a student values, okay, different results for students. Let's say you want to see the results for a certain number, certain student, that is roll number 7. You only want to see the results for roll number 7. Then what will you do you will use a DQL. That is, you will be asking that a question to the database, and you will ask that I just want to see the result for student who has roll number 7, and this DQL will provide you with the result of only that student roll number 7 and nobody else's. So we use using the statement. And it's used in SQL to see the data or to ask questions to the database. Help is not used as the other. There are 5 different kinds of statements. You have to remember DDL. You remember the full forms of this is very much important. Next, let us go to page 4. What is written here? They say that it's creating a database. So we will create a way. So you can download it. Okay. I will help you how to download it. Black screen, students, I have opened a software which has a black screen with it. Can you see it? Okay. So this software is called the MySQL software. And in this software only, whatever tables or databases or data entry we'll be doing using this software alone. Okay. You have to delete anything, you will delete from here also. So this is quite different from MS Access. In Microsoft Access, what we used to do, we had an interface where we could directly create the name of our different entries, or we can provide the values. But we do using commands. We have to write everything. So what is the command for creating a database? View the existing database on MySQL server, show database. So the first time that you have opened your this MySQL software, you want which databases are already present, because otherwise you will don't know what to do. The different databases that are already available here, we'll write the command ow databases plural. And after every command that you have written, you have to give this semicolon. Okay, show databases, and then we have given a semicolon. You will see databases that are available in my computer. So there are a total of 5 different databases, information schema. five databases are there, you can see. So I don't want to use any one of these databases. I want to create a fresh database for myself. Okay. So to do that, what will I have to do? Create, because I want to create a database. I have written the command create. I have to write the word database. This time it will be singular. In our databases, it was plural, that is show databases. But while we create it, we will be creating a single database, so we write it singular. So create database, and then we give a database name. So whatever database name, you will be providing it that particular name. So let me write. Student DB. I have written my database DB. So what is the command that I have written? Create database student, and after I will be providing a semicolon, and then I'll give the enter button. So when I create a click this enter button, the screen will update in your one also. Just wait. So after I have pressed this enter button, giving me the result as query okay and one row affected. Okay, what does this mean is that my database is created successfully. There was no error while creating the data. That's what it means. So after that, if you see our data, try to see our database again. What will we see? To see if our database is already created, what will we type? We will be typing the same show databases. Then we give semicolon again, and then we press enter. So this time, database list is again displayed, and this time you'll see this student DB database is in because it's created it. Using a particular database, we have to get into that particular database. That is, since we use student database, get inside the student database. We cannot do directly like that. So far, we have to get inside the database. How do we get the database? We have to type the command that is use, and then we have to type the database name that is is my screen visible, students? Okay, so here I had created the database, that is DB. To get inside the database, to start using the database, I had to get inside the database. This connection is again and again. So to get inside the student to start using it. So how get inside the database? To do that, I have to use this command, that is use student DB. By using this use student DB, now I am inside that particular database. And this command is also there, that is there, the database is changed. That simply means that I am right now inside the student DB. So if I now want to see, since I'm right now inside my database, right? Now what I can do, I can see what are the tables I have right now. So for that, I have to write this statement, that is show tables. This one will also be plural because table can be multiple. So I have given this statement, that is show tables. And if I press on enter, the reply is I get is empty set, since I don't have any table right now. So when I that is run the statement or the command show tables, it showed me that I don't have any table because I have just created this student database right now. So I don't have any table. So for that, to see different tables, I have to first create those tables. Okay. Otherwise, I will paste that only. Next, before creating new tables, let us learn how particular database. So to remove a database, the command drop command. So to drop whatever database we have right now created, we just type this drop. So what was our database name? Student DB. If I give one semicolon and press on enter, it will see that I have an error. What was the error? Because I did not write my database word. So after drop, I have to give the word database. Drop database and then student DB. If I press on enter this time, so you see it is showing me that query is okay and zero rows affected because no new entries I have given. I am simply deleted a particular database. So it is showing that my query is okay and now this database is deleted. We can also show command. So if I press enter, you will see in this case the student database is not displayed anymore. So we can confirm that our database is deleted. I am finishing class here only because of internet. We could do next day in next class.